Vini în cal ceva și arată. Limbare cu șareta prin canion. Vine o nouă trăsură. We'll be right back. Privește din mult tomb. Suntem la Great Temple. În Petra. Așa arată.
The big black panther came to me. I was astonished. I was afraid. I asked him, "Who are you? Please, kind of you, appear for me." He didn't answer me back. "Please, kind of you, I want to see you." She said to me, "Why do you ask me? Where are you from? What's your name? Oh my God. I told her, I'm Mahmoud. My mother, Petra, I born here. She said to me, wake up. Please, please, kind of you appear for me. She said to me again, wake up. I planted you in the swamp of this land 2,200 years ago. Wake up. You are here to spread the peace between the people. You are here to help the people. Wake up. Please, please, kind of you, appear for me. I want to see you. She said to me, you are in my blood. You are in my heart. You are in my world. At once I know her. Are you my mother, Petra? She said, yes. Please, my mother, kind of you, appear for me. I am very pleased to see you. She appeared, very, very beautiful woman, with white wings. She jumped and kissed me between my eyes. My mother. I asked her, please, my mother, tell me what's your story? She said to me, my story started 312 BC, when my people in Abatin were about 45,000 in number. My caravans used to load all kinds of stuff, such as ivory, silk, alabaster, silk caravan road. It extended from Europe to Somalia, Egypt, Arabia, South Africa, India, China. We control all the caravan routes. We exchanged goods with the merchants. He took my hand to Wadi Musa, where we start. Very green, irrigation canals, the forest. She showed me the ovens of the Nabatean pottery. Very dense, very thin. Down through the sea. The canyon, not like today. Very deep. She showed me the pavement of the Nabatean people. Three canals for the high people, mid people, poor people, but now still underneath, underground. Down. Here, she said, who are these people? She asked me, who are these people? I said to her, they are your guests. They came from all over the world to see your art, to see your rose red color, to see your temple. She said to me, my son, most of my part still underneath. 85 to 90% from my ruins still underground. But please, my son, tell my guests, my visitors, to take care of me. Sweet dream that I don't want to be away from. Ladies and gentlemen, imagine how it used to be 200 years ago. 300 years ago, with the whole Jordanian community, they were a Bedouin. They were in the caves, in the tents, to breed the Arabian horses, to race the camels. Every Bedouin guy used to carry his wallet, seven leather bag made from the goat skin or deer. It contains his pipe, herbs, meat, snacks. It's not in that time, no electricity. Flint stones, trigger fire to make the spark. Imagine how it used to be. Also, ladies and gentlemen, imagine 2,200 years ago, during the Nabatean period, imagine the power that those people had. Those who managed to carve the rock and to make it as a bronze, which is speak and express art, magic, beauty. There are no words to describe that. Petra unique, Petra still underneath. Anyhow, tomorrow, your guides will explain to you the whole history of Petra, but now, please, kind of you, close your eyes. Close your eyes, please. Connect with yourself. Take this experience into your heart forever. You can make the wish you want. One wish, please. Allah, open your eyes.
What will I do with this kind of...
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you.
I'm a two-bit, what's up?